a sinner with no vision. Drove me insane. Plenty people fall, but don't get back up again. Gotta thank the Lord that I'm back on my 10. I watch the signs of the times on my wrist like an Omnitrix. Call me Ben. Don't be hasty when you proving a friend. I done told you once, so I'ma tell you again that I keep that wisdom inside of my brain.
I'm breaking it down and I'm keeping it plain. I'm loving my brothers, ain't trying to be king. We come with that water, ain't talking about rain. I keep that wisdom inside of my brain. I'm breaking it down and I'm keeping it plain. I'm loving my brothers, ain't trying to be king. We come with that water, ain't talking about rain.
I keep that wisdom, it's all in my brain. Loosen and break off the chains. The goal is the kingdom, conversion and change. We can't stay the same. And for the word, we ain't playing no games. I'm meditating while I'm switching my lanes. If you ain't my brother, ain't knowing my pain. You ain't know my game.
He gave us strong to lose.
Let us believe a lie.
Thus said the Lord, we will never die. Long as we keep the laws and we hold the line, we will never die. No, we will never die. We will never die. But we multiply, we multiply. The instructions he's given to us. I put my faith in the Lord and the Savior. I do trust in the Lord. So I pick up the sword, learn to swing when I'm idle and bored. Run a mile through the trials and forge. Weapons for idle survival and wars. Stop all the sinning, man. Stop being timid, man. Block off emotions, don't care how you feeling, man. Ain't no forgiving them. Stop all the cheering, man. We gonna finish him as it is written, man. Not even kidding, man. It's been a minute, man. Since the beginning, man. We bout to bend it, man. Come on, let's get it, man. Up for the challenge. Please do not choke. Not talking sinner, man.
I remember growing up poor, always had to lock my door. Heat never on in the winter, AC never on in the summer. But wisdom was walking with me, but wisdom was walking with me. But wisdom was walking, but wisdom was walking, but wisdom was walking with me. I remember growing up poor, always had to lock my door. Heat never on in the winter, AC never on in the summer. But wisdom was walking with me, but wisdom was walking with me. But wisdom was walking, but wisdom was walking, but wisdom was walking with me.
Yo, that was so sin, I had a full cart. I was in the deep end with the sharks. Till I hit that button like restart. The Lord gave me a life with two parts. Young E from a poor port. True talk, but now I'm in New York and move with a new walk. Feel like hurry off the inbound with the time winding down full court. Yeah, these the moments that we practice for. This that Samson with a donkey jaw. We already know we war with Esau. And we know he like his beef raw. Yeah, we wrestling spirits. Got a power bomb for an idol. Northern kingdom, southern kingdom. Coming for the tag team titles, yeah.
I remember growing up poor. Always had to lock my door. Heat never on in the winter. AC never on in the summer. But wisdom was walking with me. But wisdom was walking with me. But wisdom was walking, but wisdom was walking, but wisdom was walking with me.
Let's get it, huh? Young prince straight from Lagos. Some may pronounce it Lagos. Our chains came at a great cause, and so would have changed the name to Slave Coast. So wisdom was walking with me. Hand in hand with demons, they was talking to me. And we were side by side like the Siamese, running up, not behind me.
Growing up, step pop was your papa. My real pops was popped on vodka. Every hustle done wants to get dollars. Every black eyes witness trauma. Altercations got dirty and bloody. Girls got impregnated by the ruddy. Black life was the Dodge cops or the yachts. So we died for the box to get locked in the box. I remember growing up wicked. I was a god, but I was stricken with madness. Wonderland like Alice. The rabbit hole filled deep with malice. But understand I'm a king. God is black, I'm worshiping. Through oppression we always sing. Demons be targeting. Whoa.
I remember growing up poor. Always had to lock my door. Heat never on in the winter. AC never on in the summer. But wisdom was walking with me. But wisdom was walking with me. But wisdom was walking, but wisdom was walking, but wisdom was walking with me.
I remember going through it in school. Got my jacket snatched, knuckles brass, skipping class just to get past the fact I couldn't dash as fast as skip the black bag. Always had to switch and find an option.
Growing up, step pop was your papa.
Walking home, I couldn't be alone. Hitting numbers, ringing at my phone. Group of niggas swinging at my dome. Trapped in this flesh, I can't get no rest. Did I deserve it or was it all a test? Found out my purpose and figured out the facts. The Lord had a time appointed. Can't touch his anointed. The same when that jump me got spun out control in the car at 100. It crashed and his body no longer responded.
I remember growing up poor. Always had to lock my door. Heat never on in the winter. AC never on in the summer. But wisdom was walking with me. But wisdom was walking with me. But wisdom was walking, but wisdom was walking, but wisdom was walking with me. I remember growing up poor. Always had to lock my door. Heat never on in the winter.
AC never on in the summer, but Wisdom was walking with me. But Wisdom was walking with me. But Wisdom was walking, but Wisdom was walking, but Wisdom was walking with me.
Hey, Shalom, Shalom, family. Most High in Christ bless. Most High in Christ bless. Can you see and hear me? Well, can you hear me? I know you're seeing the we are not a hate group right now, but okay. All right. Can you see and hear me? You see and hear me clearly? And do we have a brother that can scribe? We have a brother that can scribe this afternoon. When we get into it. Okay, all praises. Got a bunch of yeses. Josiah Judah. Okay, all praises, bro. Scribe on deck. All right, so we getting ready to get started. I'm gonna read the disclaimer. And then we're going to get started. Welcome. You are tuned in to Scripts 365, the National Scripts 365, where we read four chapters a day until we go from Genesis to Revelations, including the Apocrypha. All right. So today we're reading in the book of Isaiah, chapters 30 through 33. All right. Chapters 30 through 33. I'm Officer Kimmy Well of the Orlando Camp. I'll be doing the reading today. All right. So without any further ado, let's read the disclaimer. We are not a hate group. We are not affiliated with any other Israelite group. Israel United in Christ is a nonviolent Bible-based movement. We do not advocate or condone any acts of violence against any race, ethnicity, or gender. We advise that if anyone hears or knows of any plots to cause harm to anyone or to break the laws of the land, you must contact the proper authorities to bring awareness to any possible threat as stated in Leviticus chapter 5, verse 1 in the King James Version Bible. Because that's what we use. 1611 King James Version Bible. I want to preface this. I was watching the reading yesterday with Officer Boaz of Memphis. He did an excellent job. And I was thinking about something. For those of you that are new, there might be some new people on here that are we're going through the history, all right, and that are maybe not strong or familiar with Israelite history. I'm gonna tell you, you got to read history over and over and over again. I know for myself, I got to read things a number of times, okay? Just like the last two classes that Deacon Nathan brought out on the Sabbath, basically tearing down the Immaculate Deception, all right? Immaculate Deception doctrine by going through what? Through history, line upon line, very thorough, okay? So for many of you that may not be that strong in history, we are reading through the book of Isaiah. What I'm going to suggest to you is, first off, you get you one of these, all right? Let's see that? You get you one of those, okay? Because it has the breakdowns of the captivities like that. Man, my camera ain't that good. These daggone HPs, I don't know, man. Maybe I ain't spending enough on this HP. But anyway, so We're reading through the book of Isaiah and Assyrian captivity. And I'm just going to give you a couple of tips. What was taught to me at when I first came in into the truth, because again, many of us, especially if you grew up in the Christian church, you may have read through the Old Testament, but you weren't probably taught the Old Testament. You weren't taught it through the eyes of the Israelites. All right. So I just want to hit a couple of things. Let's go to Isaiah 1:1. Just want to show you a couple of things, because I'm not going to go through a lot of precepts in history. And the reason is because you got to learn history by reading through the Bible. But I'm going to give you some tips on how to be able to precept it together. Now, when you read it through it, one of the ways that I learned is reading through it the first time, I would precept back to laws. Okay. You read the laws and you would see certain things that we would break, and I would go back and I would precept it back to specific laws. Okay. That's one way that you get stronger in understanding the commandments and learning the history. Okay. So let's go to Isaiah 1:1 first. I'm going to make this brief and then we're going to get into the reading. Isaiah 1:1, the vision of Isaiah, the son of Amoz, which he saw concerning Judah and Jerusalem in the days of Uzziah, Jotham, Ahaz, and Hezekiah, kings of Judah. Okay, so now, what you do is you see these are the kings that he was prophesying during the times of their reigns, right? So let's go to the book of Hosea. Okay, let's go to the book of Hosea. And for those of you that are already onto this wisdom, you know, just bear with me, because again, there's new people, and we can't overstate the importance of basics. Okay, we cannot overstate the importance of basics and how to teach our people to better understand the Bible. All right, so. The book of Hosea, chapter 1, verse 1. The word of the Lord that came unto Hosea, the son of Beeri, in the days of Uzziah, Jotham, Ahaz, and Hezekiah, kings of Judah, in the days of Jeroboam, the son of Joash, king of Israel. That Jeroboam will be Jeroboam the second. Okay. So now you see that, okay. When I'm reading through the book of Isaiah, one of the major prophets, one of the so-called minor prophets, Hosea, he was prophesying around the same time, right? So the same prophets. Let's go to the book of Micah. Okay. Let's go to the book of Micah. 1:1. And it says, the word of the Lord that came to Micah, the Moreshite, in the days of Jotham, Ahaz, and Hezekiah, kings of Judah, which he saw concerning Samaria and Jerusalem. Okay, so again, you're seeing how to line up the prophets. Okay, now, one of the things... that you want to go back to also is learning, okay, where do I read about this in the Kings? And so I would suggest that you get you a who's who. I don't have mine right here, so I grabbed it for you. But a who's who in the Bible. Bear with me. I know I got one close. I mentioned it. Let me find. All right. All praise. So, again, get you you one of these. Okay? Get you a who's who in the Bible. All right? And obviously, you got your Zondervan's Compact Bible Dictionary. Now, the reason I'm saying these things is now you have weapons for your arsenal so that when you start to go through this history, because we're doing four chapters a day, all right? And we're reading the four chapters, and you'll get some precepts out of this, but that by no means is going to teach you your history, okay? You're going to have to read it, and you're going to have to read it multiple times, okay? But this is going to be your foundation, all right? So I just wanted to bring that out because as we go through Isaiah, Jeremiah, Ezekiel, and of course, you got to learn the major captivities, okay? We came out of Egypt, right? When we read through the Judges and the book of Ruth, okay? We went into captivity numerous times, but those were shorter captivities, sometimes 40 years, sometimes, you know, 10 years, all right? Because we constantly would break the commandments and cry out to the Lord for our oppression. And then the Lord was sending judges, saviors, okay? But our major captivities, you got Egypt, you got Assyria, which we're going into now with the reading of the book of Isaiah, all right? Then you got Babylon, which when we go into Jeremiah, all right, and Ezekiel, you have the Persian and Medes when we go into, you know, we read the books of Nehemiah and Ezra. I'm just naming the major prophets. There's, again, go align these up with the minor prophets as well. Then, of course, we got the Maccabees with the Greek captivity and the New Testament we reading about is Rome. Okay, so this is what we need to do so that you can better understand the history. Okay, because I'm going to tell you something. You know, I'll praise to the Most High. The last couple of Sabbath classes Deacon Athan did, I understood those. You know, those are pretty clear, straightforward, but it's because of, you know, reading and going through this history. But I know for somebody that's new, that those are some difficult classes. A lot of the classes that he does and a lot of his history Bishop brings out on Shout Out Tuesdays and Deacon Malachi bring out on the feast days, you know, you're going to have to go back and watch those classes over again, but you need to you need to have these weapons of warfare by your side, because this is spiritual warfare, as we read in 2 Corinthians chapter 10. All right. So without any further ado, let's jump into Isaiah chapter 30. All right. And we're going to read chapters 30 through 33. Okay. Isaiah chapter 30 and verse 1. Woe to the rebellious children, saith the Lord, that take counsel, but not of me, that cover with a covering, but not of my spirit, that they may add sin to sin. Now it says the rebellious children, right? That goes back to what we read in the very first chapter, okay? 1 and 4, when it says we're seed of evildoers, okay? That walk, verse 2, that walk to go down into Egypt and have not asked at my mouth. Meaning, he's saying it again. We haven't taken counsel with the Lord. Is this what we should be doing? Or are we leaning to our own understanding? All right. It says they walk to go down into Egypt and have not asked in my mouth to strengthen themselves in the strength of Pharaoh and to trust in the shadow of Egypt. Therefore, shall the strength of Pharaoh be your shame and the trust in the shadow of Egypt your confusion. For his princes were at Zoan and his ambassadors came to Hanes. They were all ashamed of a people that could not profit them, nor be in help, nor profit, but a shame and also a reproach. Because you got to understand, there were numerous times that the heathen nations would come up, you know, to oppress us. And you had kings that would seek the guidance of the Lord. And then you had kings that would seek the aid of other heathen kings to fight battles for us. In this case, the Lord is saying woe to us for going back to Egypt and asking help of Pharaoh. Okay. Verse 6, the burden of the beasts of the south into the land of trouble and anguish. From whence come the young and old lion, the viper and fiery serpent? They will carry their riches upon the shoulders of the young asses, and their treasures upon the bunches of camels, to a people that shall not profit them. For the Egyptians shall help in vain. And we read the same thing in Lamentation. Same thing happened when we were in the Babylonian captivity. And you know what? The same thing is happening today. Okay? A people that cannot profit us. All right? Verse 7 again. For the Egyptians shall help in vain, and to no purpose. Therefore have I cried concerning this. Their strength is to sit still. Now go, write it before them in a book, in a table, and note it in a book, that it may be for a time to come forever and ever. So what is the Most High telling us? He's telling the prophet Isaiah to go and write these things. Remember when we read in Romans 15 and 4, things written aforetime were written for our learning. So what are we reading now? You can't trust these heathen nations. These heathen nations can't deliver us. Paul wrote that during the time of what? Roman captivity. Now we're reading it here in the time of the Assyrian captivity, showing you nothing has changed. Okay, nothing has changed. All right, verse 9. That this is a rebellious people, lying children, children that will not hear the law of the Lord. And it's happening the same way today. Our pastors are telling us that the laws are done away with. I just watched a video this morning, Captain Hoshea teaching, and a foolish pastor came up all proud, got cut up, then he had to go run away. You know? Don't want to. He said the laws are done away with. Yeah, the laws are done away with. So, again, it said that this is a rebellious people, lying children, that will not hear the law of the Lord, which say to the seers, see not, and to the prophets, prophesy not unto us right things, speak unto us smooth things, prophesy deceits. Get you out of the way, turn aside out of the path, cause the Holy One of Israel to cease from before us. Why would you want the Holy One of Israel to cease from before you? Because you love this oppression. You love the ways of your slave masters. Wherefore, thus saith the Holy One of Israel, because ye despise this word and trust in oppression and perverseness and stay thereon, therefore this iniquity shall be to you as a breach ready to fall, swelling out in a high wall, whose breaking cometh suddenly at an instant, and he shall break it as the breaking of the potter's vessel that is broken in pieces. He shall not spare, so that there shall not be found in the bursting of it a sherd to take fire from the hearth, or to take water withal out of the pit. For thus saith the Lord God, the Holy One of Israel, in returning and rest ye shall be saved. In quietness and in confidence shall be your strength, and ye would not. But ye say, now, this is what our response is. But ye say, no, for we will flee upon horses, therefore shall ye flee, and we will ride upon the swift, therefore shall they that pursue you be swift. 1,000 shall flee at the rebuke of one. At the rebuke of five shall ye flee, till ye be left as a beacon upon the top of a hill and as an ensign on an hill. And therefore will the Lord wait, that he may be gracious unto you, and therefore will he be exalted, that he may have mercy upon you. For For the Lord is a God of judgment. Blessed are all they that wait for him. So what does that mean? Blessed are all they that wait for him. That means that we have to have patience when we endure in these trials and tribulations. Now, let's see that in the New Testament, because Christ said the same thing. Christ said the same thing. Let's get that in Luke. Let's get that in Luke. Let me find it right quick. Let's get that in Luke chapter 21, verse 19. It says, in your patience, possess ye your souls. In your patience, possess ye your souls. So let's go back. And let's read Isaiah 30 and 18 again. And it says, and therefore will the Lord wait, that he may be gracious unto you. And therefore will he be exalted, that he may have mercy upon you. For the Lord is a God of judgment. Blessed, here's the point, blessed are all they that wait for him. Okay, so while we're going through these trials and tribulations, you know, and people are coming at you saying, man, why you believe in that Bible? They've been talking about Jesus for thousands of years, and ain't nobody coming to save us, and you got to save yourself, you got to take up guns, or whatever the case may be. These are the things that we hear on a daily basis. We hear them in camp, you hear them flyer missions, you might hear them from your own family members. But you have to, you know, the scriptures also say that, let's get that in Philippians, Philippians 2. Let's get that right quick. Philippians chapter 2 and verse 12. It says, wherefore, my beloved, as ye have always obeyed, not as in my presence only, but now much more in my absence, work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. So you're going to have those that are going to come. They're going to bring false doctrines. They're going to try to sway you what you're doing is fruitless. Okay, it's useless. Like, why are you waiting on a guy that ain't coming to save you? Hey, you got to exercise patience. You got to stay steadfast, right? Let me get one more to help with that understanding. One more. Let's get the book of Psalms. Psalms chapter 1, and we're going to read 1 through 3. We're going to stop at 3. 1 through 3. Blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful. Okay, those are going to come up upon you, and they're going to try to draw you out. Look, some of them are going to be your family members, all right? They might be your wives, your husbands, your children, your mother, you know, that favorite cousin, you know. And some of them are going to be longtime friends, okay? But it says, blessed is a man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful. But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law doth he meditate day and night. That's how you develop patience also. Meditation in the commandments. All right, verse 3. Here's the point. And he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water that bringeth forth his fruit in his season. His leaf also shall not wither, and whatsoever he doeth shall prosper. Okay? But that wisdom's not going to come overnight. All right, that wisdom is not going to come overnight. That's why you have to have patience. You got to endure. You're going to have to labor. You got to labor in these scripts, and you're going to have to endure when you're keeping these commandments and people try to ridicule you. Okay, especially our own people. All right, so let's go back. Isaiah chapter 30, verse 19. For the people shall dwell in Zion at Jerusalem. Thou shalt weep no more. He will be very gracious unto thee at the voice of thy cry. When he shall hear it, he will answer thee. And though the Lord give you the bread of adversity and the water of affliction, yet shall not thy teachers be removed into a corner anymore. but thine eyes shall see thy teachers. And that's what you see in the day. Even right now, us having the ability to teach on these platforms. Today, right now, you're in the Scripts 365, the four chapters. You got daily bread. You got radio shows, as well as the Sabbath and us going out on the street corner. So he said, although the Lord give you the bread of adversity and the water of affliction, yet shall not thy teachers be removed into a corner anymore, but thine eyes shall see thy teachers. And the bishop and deacon and captains and officers were just in Guyana. So now they're seeing their teachers, okay? Building up the camps there, all right? Verse 21. And thine eyes shall hear a word behind thee, saying, this is the way, walk ye in it. When you turn to the right hand and when you turn to the left, how are your ears going to hear? Because the men are going to be out on the street teaching, all right? Verse 22. You shall defile also the covering of thy graven images of silver and the ornament of thy molten images of gold. Thou shalt cast them away as a menstrual cloth. Thou shalt say unto it, get thee hence. And you've seen, you all have borne witness watching some of our videos where people will literally take those idolatrous crosses and onks and things off at camp and cast them away. Okay, so what you're seeing is that these prophecies that we are reading are coming true in this very day. All right. Verse 23, then shall he give the rain of thy seed, that thou shalt sow the ground withal, and the bread of the increase of the earth, and it shall be fat and plenteous. In that day shall thy cattle feed in large pastures, the oxen likewise, and the young asses that ear the ground shall eat clean provender, which have been winnowed with the shovel and with the fan. And there shall be upon every high mountain and upon every high hill, rivers and streams of water in the day of the great slaughter when the towers fall. Moreover, the light of the moon shall be as the light of the sun, and the light of the sun shall be sevenfold as the light of 7 days. In the day that the Lord bindeth up the breach of his people and healeth the stroke of their wound. Behold, the name of the Lord cometh from far, burning with his anger, and the burden thereof is heavy. His lips are full of indignation, and his tongue as a devouring fire, and his breath as an overflowing stream shall reach to the midst of the neck, to sift the nations with the sieve of vanity. And there shall be a bridle in the jaws of the people, causing them to err. Ye shall have a song, as in the night when a holy solemnity is kept, and gladness of heart, as when one goeth with a pipe to come into the mountain of the Lord, to the mighty one of Israel. And this reminds me of when King David came back from the slaughter. If y'all remember the history, when his wife Michal got mad because he was dancing, he said, hey, he was giving praise to the Lord. She said, you like one of the shameless ones, because he was dancing so hard, he was coming out his clothes. The Lord said, we're going to be like that. We're going to be joyful in that day. When you say, you know what, we ain't got to work these long hours no more. When we ain't got to worry about getting shot down in the street, worry about people kicking in our doors, worry about losing our houses because we can't afford to rent or pay the taxes. That's going to be a joyful day when we don't have to worry about those things anymore. Verse 30, and the Lord shall cause his glorious voice to be heard, and shall show the lightning down of his arm with the indignation of his anger, and with the flame of a devouring fire, with scattering and tempest and hailstones. For through the voice of the Lord shall the Assyrian be beaten down, which smote with a rod. And in every place where the ground is staff shall pass, which the Lord shall lay upon him, it shall be with tabrets and harps, and in battles of shaking, will he fight with it? For Tophet is ordained of old, yea, for the king is prepared. He hath made it deep and large. The pile thereof is fire and much wood. The breath of the Lord, like a stream of brimstone, doth kindle it. Okay? All right, so that is Isaiah chapter 30. Let's go to Isaiah chapter 31. It says, woe unto them that go down to Egypt for help. That's the same thing we read at the beginning of 30. Let's make it more plain. And stay on horses and trust in chariots, because they are many, and horsemen, because they are very strong. But they look not unto the Holy One of Israel, neither seek the Lord. You know what that's going into? Let's get that in Ecclesiastes. Let's get that in Ecclesiastes. Say, we don't look to the Lord. Okay. Let's see why. Let's see why. Ecclesiastes 7 and 7. Surely oppression maketh the wise man mad. Here's the point. And a gift destroyeth the heart. And a gift destroyeth the heart. So when we go back, let's read 31 and 1 again. Woe to them that go down to Egypt for help, and stay on horses, and trust in chariots, because they are many, and in horsemen, because they are very strong. But they look not unto the Holy One of Israel, neither seek the Lord. Look at our people today, all right? We honor him by our lips, right? But when our oppressor gives us gifts, we turn away from the Lord. All right. We turn away and we serve our oppressor's will. Let me jump ahead. Let me see if I can find it right quick. No, you know what? I'm gonna hold off on that. I'm gonna hold off on that because we in 33. We'll read tomorrow this history. We'll read tomorrow, 34, 35, 36. Yes, I think we'll read it tomorrow or Friday about the horses and the chariots, okay? Because the Assyrians, remember now, we're reading about the time of the Assyrian captivity, and the Assyrians came up against King Hezekiah. And I think it was Rabshakeh. Yeah, Rabshakeh was speaking unto them. And he said he had horses. If you can, let me see if I can find it right quick. Let me just see if I can find it right quick. Here we go. Okay. I'm gonna read. You're gonna read it again tomorrow. We're gonna read it again tomorrow, but I'm gonna jump ahead just for a second. Go to Isaiah 36 and verse 1. Isaiah 36 and 1. It says, "Now it came to pass in the 14th year of Hezekiah that Sennacherib, king of Assyria, came up against all the defense cities of Judah and took them." Now I'm gonna jump down to verse 6. It says, "Lo, thou trustest in the staff of this broken reed on Egypt, whereon if a man lean, it will go into his hand and pierce it. So is Pharaoh, king of Egypt, to all that trust in him. But if thou say to me, we trust in the Lord our God, is it not he whose high places and whose altars Hezekiah hath taken away and said to Judah and Jerusalem, ye shall worship before this altar? Now, therefore, give pledges." Now, here's the point. Here's the reason I went to the Ecclesiastes 7 and 7. He says, "Now, therefore, give pledges, I pray thee, to my master, the king of Assyria, and I will give thee 2,000 horses, if thou be able on thy part to set riders upon them." Okay, so when they come with gifts, right? That's why I went there. It says a gift destroyed the heart. Then we're not focusing on the Lord no more, right? We turn into our oppressors. And then we get lulled back into the false sense that our oppressors is going to deliver us. Okay. Same trick that we keep falling for. All right. So let's go back. Isaiah 31 and 2. Yet he also is wise and will bring evil and will not call back his words, but will arise against the house of the evildoers and against the help of them that work iniquity. Now the Egyptians are men and not God, and their horses flesh and not spirit. When the Lord shall stretch out his hand, both he that helpeth shall fall, and he that is hoping shall fall down, and they all shall fail together. Okay, you see that? That's why it says that they couldn't help us, a nation that can't help you. Because the Lord decides, you know what? I'm punishing you and them for trying to help you, going against my word. All right, we're going to read some more of that when we get into the book of Jeremiah. All right, verse 4. For thus saith the Lord, For thus hath the Lord spoken unto me, like as a lion and the young lion roaring on his prey, when a multitude of shepherds is called forth against him, he will not be afraid of their voice, nor abase himself for the noise of them. So shall the Lord of hosts come down to fight for Mount Zion and for the hill thereof. As birds flying, so will the Lord of hosts defend Jerusalem. Defending also, he will deliver it, and passing over, he will preserve it. Turn ye unto him from whom the children of Israel have deeply revolted. You see that? It says, turn ye unto him from whom the children of Israel have deeply revolted. That revolt means rebel. Woe to the rebellious children. All right. Verse 7. For in that day every man shall cast away his idols of silver and his idols of gold, which your hands have made unto you for a sin. Then shall the Assyrian fall with the sword, not of a mighty man and the sword, not of a mean man shall devour him, but he shall flee from the sword, and his young men shall be discomfited, and he shall pass over to his stronghold for fear, and his princes shall be afraid of the ensign, saith the Lord, whose fire is in Zion and his furnace in Jerusalem. Okay, so when the Lord come and he's bringing forth his judgment, it ain't nothing that the heathen nations can do. All right, that's why we got to wait. We got to be patient. Okay, he's waiting for us to get ourselves together. All right, verse 32 or chapter 32. Behold, a king shall reign in righteousness, and princes shall rule in judgment. And a man shall be as an hiding place from the wind, and a covert from the tempest, as rivers of water in a dry place, as the shadow of a great rock in a weary land. And the eyes of them that shall see, shall not be dim, and the ears of them that hear shall hearken. So, let me read that again, and then we're going to go back a couple of chapters. It says, and the eyes of them that see shall not be dim, and the ears of them that hear shall hearken. So you're going to start to see things spiritually, and you're going to be able to hear with understanding, right? Let's go back to Isaiah. Let me find it right quick. Because Christ said this in the New Testament, but he got it from here. Okay, Isaiah 6 and 9. Isaiah chapter 6, verse 9. And he said, go, tell this people, hear ye indeed, but understand not. See ye indeed, but perceive not. Make the heart of this people fat, and make the ears heavy, and shut their eyes, lest they should see with their eyes and hear with their ears and understand with their heart and convert and be healed. Okay? And convert and be healed. Wait a minute. Let's go to John, St. John, chapter 12, verse 39. No, let's start at verse 37. John, chapter 12, verse 37. Now, this is speaking of Christ. But though he had done so many miracles before them, yet they believed not on him, that the saying of Isaiah the prophet might be fulfilled, which he spake, Lord, who hath believed our report, and to whom hath the arm of the Lord been revealed? Therefore they could not believe, because that Isaiah said again, he hath blinded their eyes and hardened their heart, that they should not see with their eyes, nor understand with their heart, and be converted, and I should heal them. And I should heal them. So let's go back to Isaiah chapter 32. Isaiah chapter 32 and verse 3. And the eyes of them that see shall not be dim, and the ears of them that hear shall hearken. The heart also of the rash shall understand knowledge, and the tongue of the stammerers shall be ready to speak plainly. The vile person shall no more be called liberal, nor the churl said to be bountiful. For the vile person will speak villainy in his heart, will work iniquity, to practice hypocrisy, and to utter error against the Lord, to make empty the soul of the hungry, and he will cause the drink of the thirsty to fail. The instruments also of the churl are evil. He deviseth wicked devices to destroy the poor with lying words, even when the needy speaketh right. But the liberal deviseth liberal things, and by liberal things shall he stand. Rise ye up, ye women that are at ease. Hear my voice, ye careless daughters, and give ear to my speech. Many days and years shall ye be troubled, ye careless women, for the vintage shall fail, the gathering shall not come. Tremble, ye women that are at ease, be troubled, ye careless ones, strip you and make you bare, and gird sackcloth upon your loins. They shall lament for the teats, for the pleasant fields, for the fruitful vine. Upon the land of my people shall come up thorns and briars. Yea, upon the all the houses of joy in the joyous city, because the palaces shall be forsaken, the multitude of the city shall be left, the forts and towers shall be for dens forever, a joy of wild asses, a pasture of flocks, until, listen to this, until the Spirit be poured upon us from high, and the wilderness be a fruitful field, and the fruitful field be counted for a forest. Then judgment shall dwell in the wilderness, and righteousness remain in the fruitful field. And the work of righteousness shall be peace, and the effect of righteousness, quietness and assurance forever. So wait a minute. This is the prophecy of when the Lord is going to pour his Spirit on us, right? I'm going to read that again. It says in verse 15, It says, until the Spirit be poured upon us from high, and the wilderness be a fruitful field, and the fruitful field be counted for a forest, then judgment shall dwell in the wilderness, and righteousness remain in the fruitful field. And the work of righteousness shall be peace, and the effect of righteousness, quietness, and assurance forever. Let me get, go to Baruch. The book of Baruch. Because even our forefathers in Baruch, which is in the Babylonian captivity, understood this thing. Baruch chapter 3. I'm going to start at verse 10. Start at verse 10. It says, how happeneth it, Israel, that thou art in thine enemy's land? Thou art waxing old in a strange country. Thou art defiled with the dead, that thou art counted with them that go down into the grave. Thou hast forsaken the fountain of wisdom. We have forsaken our Lord. It says, thou hast forsaken the fountain of wisdom. Here's the point. For if thou hadst walked in the way of God, thou shouldest have dwelled in peace forever. If we had walked in the ways of God, so what is that telling us? That we departed. If we had walked in the ways of God, we should have dwelled in peace forever. Let's go back to Isaiah chapter 32, verse 15. Until the Spirit be poured upon us from high, and the wilderness be a fruitful field, and the fruitful field be counted for a forest, then judgment shall dwell in the wilderness, and righteousness remain in the fruitful field, and the work of righteousness shall be peace. You see that? The work of righteousness, okay, shall be peace. When we're applying righteousness, we will be in peace among each other. What did Christ preach? Christ preached peace, okay, among the brethren. Paul preached peace among the brethren, all right? Verse 17 again, and the work of righteousness shall be peace, and the effect of righteousness, quietness and assurance forever. And my people shall dwell in a peaceable habitation. Are we dwelling in a peaceable habitation right now? Absolutely not. That's why Deuteronomy 28:16 says, cursed in the city and cursed in the field. Why are we cursed in the city? Because we got high rates of crime, black on black crime against each other, all right? Verse 18 again, and my people shall dwell in a peaceable habitation and in sure dwellings and in quiet resting places. When it shall hail, coming down on the forest, and the city shall be low in a low place. Blessed are they that sow beside all waters, that send forth thither the feet of the ox and the ass. Okay, so that's what we're waiting on. We are waiting on that peace to return unto us. I'm gonna leave it there. See, now I got a couple more precepts I want to go to. I'm gonna leave it there. We're gonna go into Isaiah chapter 33 and verse 1 now. All right, Isaiah chapter 33, verse 1. Woe to thee that spoilest, and thou wast not spoiled, and dealest treacherously, and they dealt not treacherously with thee. When thou shalt cease to spoil, thou shalt be spoiled. And when thou shalt make an end to deal treacherously, they shall deal treacherously with thee. O Lord, be gracious unto us. We have waited for thee. You see that? There again, patience, patience. It says, you know what? Hold on just a second. I want to read Psalms 131 right quick. Book of Psalms 131, King David. Remember, King David was a man after God's heart. So I want to read the spirit of King David. This is Psalms chapter 131, verse 1. Lord, my heart is not haughty, nor my eyes lofty, neither do I exercise myself in great matters or in things too high for me. Surely I have behaved and quieted myself as a child that is weaned of his mother. My soul is even as a weaned child. Here's a point right here in verse 3. Let Israel hope in the Lord from henceforth and forever. Let Israel hope in the Lord from henceforth and forever. The reason I'm reading some of these precepts is because I know, and we're getting close to Passover, that brothers and sisters' spirits can get shaky, okay? So to restore you, to heal you, we got to bring forth the word and bringing forth scriptures to let you know that even when you are going through trials and tribulations, that's when you your faith is being tested. That's when Sirach 2 needs to be applied. And I wanted to read the spirit of David. He said, let Israel hope in the Lord. This is when, that's why we read in Psalms 1. This is the time that you have to gird up your loins and tough it out. Go through these trials, these tribulations. Seek guidance, seek correction. Get into the scriptures, meditate. All right? Because I'm going to read that again. Isaiah 33 and verse 2. O Lord, be gracious unto us. We have waited for thee. Okay? We have waited for thee. We are exercising patience as we go through these trials and tribulations. All right? It says, be thou their arm every morning, our salvation also in the time of trouble. At the noise of the tumult of the people fled. At the lifting up of thyself, the nations were scattered. And spoil, and your spoil shall be gathered like the gathering of the caterpillar, as the running to and fro of locusts shall he run upon them. The Lord is exalted, for he dwelleth on high. He hath filled Zion with judgment and righteousness. Wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability of thy times, and the strength of salvation, the fear of the Lord is his treasure. Let's read that again. And wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability of thy times. Wisdom and knowledge, that's what's going to get us through with these tribulations. Okay, wisdom and knowledge, staying steadfast. It says that shall be the stability of thy times. And strength of salvation, the fear of the Lord is his treasure. So let's get 2 Timothy right quick. 2 Timothy. Okay, wisdom and knowledge is the stability of thy times. Let's see. Where do I want to start? I'm gonna read verse 1, and I'm gonna jump down to 14. This is a true saying. If a man desired the office of a bishop, he desired a good work. We've read this before. Verse 14. These things write I unto thee, hoping to come unto thee shortly. But if I tarry long, that thou mayest know how thou oughtest to behave thyself in the house of God, which is the church of the living God, the pillar and ground of the truth. The pillar and ground of the truth. Who is the church of God? We are the church of God, the Israelites. Okay, we ought to know how to behave ourselves. We got to know and apply how to possess our vessels. Okay, how to constrain ourselves from sin. Okay, 2 Corinthians 5:14 says the love of Christ constraineth us. All right, so let's go back. Isaiah 33:6, and wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability of thy times. What is that wisdom and that knowledge? It's the commandments of the Lord. Okay, we know wisdom, Deuteronomy 4:5, knowledge, Malachi 2:7. All right, it's the stability of thy times and the strength of salvation. The fear of the Lord is his treasure. Behold, their valiant ones shall cry without. The ambassadors of peace shall weep bitterly. The highways lay waste. The wayfaring man ceaseth. He hath broken the covenant. He hath despised the cities. He regardeth no man. The earth mourneth and languisheth. Lebanon is ashamed and hewn down. Sharon is like a wilderness. And Bashan and Carmel shake off their fruits. Now will I rise, saith the Lord. Now will I be exalted. Now will I lift up myself. Ye shall conceive chaff. Ye shall bring forth stubble. Your breath as fire shall devour you. And the people shall be as the burnings of lime, as thorns cut up shall they be burned in the fire. Hear, ye that are far off, what I have done, that ye that are near acknowledge my might. The sinners in Zion are afraid. Fearfulness hath surprised the hypocrites. You see that? Fearfulness hath surprised the hypocrites. That's that breaking in an instant. Lord is going to come upon us in an instant. All right? So you got to be preparing yourself. Who among us shall dwell with the devouring fire? Who among us shall dwell with everlasting burnings? He that walketh righteously and speaketh uprightly, he that despiseth the gain of oppression, that shaketh his hand from holding of bribes, that stoppeth his ears from hearing of blood, and shutteth his eyes from seeing evil, he shall dwell on high. His place of defense shall be in the munitions of rocks. Bread shall be given him, his waters shall be sure. Thine eyes shall see the king in his beauty. They shall behold the land that is very far off. What land? Our homeland. Why is it very far off? Because where are we? Scattered throughout the four corners of the earth in Babylon, far and near from our homeland. All right. Thine heart shall meditate terror. Where is the scribe? Where is the receiver? Where is he that counteth the towers? Thou shalt not see the fierce people, a people of deeper speech than thou canst perceive, of a stammering tongue thou canst not understand. Look upon Zion, the city of our solemnities. Thine eyes shall see Jerusalem, a quiet habitation, a tabernacle that shall not be taken down. Not one of the stakes thereof shall ever be removed, neither shall any of the cords thereof be broken. But there the glorious Lord will be unto us a place of broad rivers and streams, wherein shall go no galley with oars, neither shall gallant ship pass thereby. For the Lord is our judge, the Lord is our lawgiver, the Lord is our king, he will save us. Thy tacklings are loose, they cannot well strengthen their mast, they cannot spread their sail. Then is the prey of a great spoil divided. The lame take the prey. You see that? The lame take the prey. Because remember, in that day, even the feeble among us will be as David. Okay? When we get our new bodies. All right? And the inhabitant shall not say, I am sick. The people that dwell therein shall be forgiven their iniquity. That's something to look forward to. And that tells you that those people that are in Jerusalem today are not the real Jews. All right. All right. So that'll conclude our four chapters a day. We read Isaiah chapter 30, 31, 32, and 33. So I pray it's been edifying to you. Remember to tune in to our classes three times a day, our radio shows. TGIF is coming up in a couple of days. Get ready for Passover. Get ready for Passover. I pray I get to see a lot of you, meet you that I don't know at Passover. But it's down here in sunny Florida. Lord willing that the Lord will make it sunny during that time. Some of y'all won't bring the snow and the rain down here with you when you travel. All right. And leave the corona at home. All right. Make sure you donate. All right. And if you have not joined the Boosters Club, do so. All right. So, again, this has been four chapters a day. Prayer has been edifying. Shalom. Most High in Christ bless you all.
Look, let me talk to y'all real quick, man. Yeah, do your thing, man. I got a couple things to say, and I'ma slow it down. Yeah. Ain't no more hyping this. Look, look,
nice working with you, Mario.
Look, I'm dedicating my life to the book of the Lord. from chasing my death to living with my sword. I gotta battle myself, cause I'm my own oppressor. Because the spirit is life, flesh belongs on a stretcher. Look, spirit and flesh is just a hero and villain. One be cleaving to God, other chasing the feeling. My flesh be starving for lust, spirit be steady eating. From the words of the book that's keeping me from sleeping. Spiritual sleep so you can get the message. That sleeping brings sin, causing your body some wreckage. Cause when your lust conceive, your body catch disease. From STDs to Hep B and C. I got a plan A, there ain't no B and C. Be a prophet of God and let your brother see. Cause when they see that's a change, that's who they wanna be. That was the ABCs written to you and me. The Bible changed my mind just like a brain surgeon. No more learning from lies, we got the real version. Trying to learn all the deep things got your brain hurting. Live your life off of milk just like a baby nursing. Denying the flesh, it be the main purpose. That's why we pray real fast, repenting with the flesh. When your spirit at rest, know that the flesh is working. Ain't no clowns in this truth, cause this is not a circus. If you wanna act, this ain't the right place. The only thing that we act is Judges 5:11. And we keep in the faith, Hebrews chapter 11. Keep the faith in the laws to make your way to heaven. Now the point of this song, it gets simple as this. You got a spirit and flesh, so it begin with this. Examine yourself to make the holy list. It's really you versus you. If you ain't catch my drift.